Welcome to the 2012-2013 Cheer Extreme season. We are honored and thrilled to have JT following us in an inside look this season, inside and outside of cheerleading. We want to take you all the way through warm-ups and through practices, through the grueling preparation, so that what you see you can even really even more appreciate on the mat for competition. Welcome to Colfax. This is where I grew up, right next door, my mom and dad. My dad always wanted me to have horses. He's a big horse guy, so he was all into that. But unfortunately, I just had a little leotard on in the backyard and wanted to teach myself how to be a gymnast. Always had dreams of going to the Olympics, and that never really happened, but I'll take the gold medal in 2012 and 2010 as satisfaction for that dream. This is our home. We had a couple people write in and say that they really wanted to get an inside look at what, you know, our lives were all about, which we have no problem sharing with the audience. We are very interested in supporting All-Star Cheerleading, helping it grow, and maximizing participants. Overall, we hope to be able to do that by mentoring some young coaches out there who are watching the video and want to make a program successful. This is where I like to think lots of magic happens, but really I just get caught up checking Facebook like everybody else does and all the different instant media gratification there is in cheerleading. But this is my office, obviously painted kind of teal, and this is where we kind of make all the decisions happen and choreograph some routines and of course watch great videos by JT, who is following us this season, which we're so grateful to have. We are doing these videos for many reasons. First of all, they're great for our kids and their long distance relatives who don't get to see the, really what they do, because I believe that All-Star Cheerleading, while we go to competitions and we reap the rewards of what happens on the mat, the real lessons and the real value to what I do for a living happen in the gym. And so I'm so thankful to have JT this season to really capture those wins, which for an athlete growing up through the sport are often more valued and more remembered than anything that happens in a competition setting that's available on YouTube. I do know that there are coaches and gym owners across the country who have aspirations to be able to coach cheerleading for a living. I hope to be a mentor to as many of you that watch this at home. If you ever have any questions or you want some commentary or some suggestion on how to build up a program, I would love to help. I grew up right next door here and always dreamed of having my own gym. I remember one of my neighbors one time, they were building a house. I must have been 7 or 8. They were building a house in our neighborhood and she goes, "Oh, Courtney, is that your gym that they're building over there?" And of course I was like, "Well, it will be one day, but no, that's just, you know, somebody's house." But that memory has stuck with me and I was fortunate enough to be able to carry out our dreams and move in right next door to my mom and dad and build the house that we love, that we often share with all of our teams. We have sleepovers almost every weekend with the various teams in our program. There are so many lessons that All-Star Cheerleading gives, the most important of which is family and long-distance connections and long-term connections that you build family to family. Most people that are involved with cheerleading, especially currently in politics and cheerleading, would venture to guess that I'm not exactly for the changes that have been made in the past couple months. I think some of them are definitely for a benefit, and some of them maybe. And we, you know, once we get through them, I may completely change my mind. But what I do know is that we have just not even scratched the surface of what All-Star Cheerleading could be, what it could serve the purpose for in so many more kids' lives. And I'm all for whatever the USASF, varsity, all of the big corporations out there, we all want the same thing, which is we want more people to come in and see what a great activity this is. But from my perspective, and it's limited to my little corner of the universe, I see us in the gym, I just think that there are more things that we're able to do. I watch kids conquer their dreams every single day and push themselves to certain limits, and then they're able to surpass those. You know, when I watched the Olympic Games all summer, I saw kids, they don't have a certain number of times they're able to flip before they hit the water. They surpass themselves. The sport, in essence, beats itself every single time out for the games. And I see All-Star Cheerleading really just getting started to grasp all of the things that we can achieve as a sport. I do know sometimes that the athleticism of it can place certain athletes out of it, but I think that what's so beautiful about All-Star Cheerleading is that we do have a leveling system. Kids can take it at their own pace. There is a certain level of expertise that level 5 athletes carry, but even in the webinar that was available for Varsity All-Star a couple weeks ago, you know, the stunts that were the deal even 2 years ago, even three years ago especially, are bare minimums of what you have to do to be able to compete now. And I don't think anybody's even thought about, what are we going to be doing in 3 years? I'm excited by that potential, and I think the kids are too. And if I was going to be an athlete that's going to be invested in something for 10 long years, I would want to know that there's something out there that has not been introduced that I get to try to work on next summer. What's the new, next, greatest, best thing? Have we really gotten to the place where we have achieved all there is to achieve in our sport, and now we just get to see who can do it the most timed together? I hope not. We have two little girls that are in All-Star Cheerleading pretty fiercely, and I don't want to feel like those kids have already kind of reached the top of where they are in our sport. And I know the others share the belief that these kids, and our coaches especially, don't deserve to be limited in any way. I was very blessed coming up through the ranks of the sport to be mentored by some of the very brightest, most amazing minds in the sport. The folks even at Charlotte All-Stars and at Gym Time and Cheer Athletics, all these coaches were our inspiration. Some of them took special time out to teach and pass down lessons that I use every single day when I'm in the gym. Unfortunately, a lot of these key influential people in our sport are 10 years older than I am and are, you know, are experiencing, they are sitting behind desks and they're CEOs of companies, and they're not in the gym anymore. And they're not able to pass down those trade secrets or those, you know, techniques. And what I'd like to see are the young 30-year-old coaches, or my peers, really pass the torch down. And those kids that are coming out of college that want to make a career out of cheerleading, I want to see us take some time and pass along everything that has gotten us to this place where we are right now. My concern is that the gap between the leaders and the kids coming up through the generation now, there's such an age gap that we may never get that passed down. And we started the next generation of leaders, sponsored by Infinity and by GK, to help accelerate the growth of the learning of all of the kids coming up who really, really want to make their mark in cheerleading. It is my hope that these people with their creative minds, who actually were All-Star cheerleaders, because most of the people who make the decisions right now in All-Star cheerleading never even participated in the sport they created. They were never All-Star cheerleaders, they just made it a sport or an activity, and we are all being dictated by those people, and they are doing a phenomenal job. But what is next? What's on the horizon? What can we do? What's in the coming years? And I hope that the kids who absorb All-Star cheerleading and it's so much a part of who they are able to leave a mark on the sport. I wanted to give some of the fans a tour and just talk to you a little bit about some of the traditions that we think so fondly of here at Cheer Extreme. When Ben and I were designing our home, we had the team over in 2009 that summer, and we just had totally, we felt like that season we were really in a better place than we'd ever been before as far as our routine went. And those of you who have been following Senior Elite for a couple years know that that was one of the first years that we were really truly on the scene competitively and really were going as hard as possible for the gold medal. And that year my home was just in building mode, and so there's no paint on any walls, and so behind this nook we cut out the dimensions of the World Trophy that we hoped one day we would be able to bring home. And so the girls that season wrote their names on the wall of the frame of the house, and we have had a big party over here, roasted marshmallows, and just kind of like celebrated what was to be. So then 2009 turned out we did the best we possibly could. We had a minor mistake in finals that cost us the season that year. And coming off of that season of high hopes and just believing in ourselves, we really decided to take cheerleading in a different direction. Well, we didn't know at the time we were going to be taking cheerleading in a different direction. We just decided to stop doing everything everybody else was doing great and start focusing on what our strengths were. And again, for those of you that have followed us, this routine that we came up with in 2010, by all respects, it really kind of changed cheerleading, put stunting and elite stunning in a new format, showcasing some talent that had not ever been seen before. That was the year of Maddie's 360 ball up and some fantastic music that JR put together for us. We used Celine Dion, My Heart Will Go On, for our pyramid that season. And I decided that summer not to watch any YouTube videos, not to concentrate at all on what any of our competitors were doing, and instead to just focus on what made Cheer Extreme, specifically Senior Elite. So every single, I'm gonna cry, but every single day that year, I walked by this on my way to the bedroom and back, and I placed a little good luck charm in our little nook here. And it was believe or a note that one of the kids gave me, and I promised them that this year was gonna be the year we were gonna finally bring it home. And so walking out right before we left for Worlds that season, you know, I had a little conversation with the nook, and I'm like, when I come home, we're gonna have something to put in this case finally. So what you see here is the actual gold medal trophy from 2010, when they actually really did pull it off. And it was absolutely one of the most breathtaking moments of my life. The girls that in prelims were absolutely perfect came into finals with a sizable lead. We made a mistake, but thanks to an awesome crowd and some great fan support, they kept it together and knew that their routine could handle a mistake as long as they didn't make another one. And from believing in themselves, they pulled off the impossible. And after 12 years of being in the large senior division and coming up short, we finally pulled it off and brought home the world champion banner to Kernersville. And so the night that we placed this finally in its home, we had all the kids line the staircase and pass candles down through the team. And then we passed the actual trophy back down. And we had all of them, they signed actually the back of the wall during the course of the season before we won, just with all kinds of believing in themselves and hope that we, then after the fact, then those that hadn't signed it yet actually got to. So you'll see some really awesome cheerleaders from 2010 who are forever kind of embedded here in our home. This year, we had quite the season from a really scary showcase. We actually had to do our routine 3 times. We beat all kinds of odds as the season went on, and the team just progressed and progressed throughout the season. I think one of the things that is the most telling about that group of kids in 2012 is that they just never really gave up on themselves, and we kept beating ourselves. And we really truly considered our competitors that season to be in a level that we weren't sure we could even attain. And so instead of focusing on, you know, trying to compete with the great World Cup and the awesome team from F5, we just try to beat ourselves every week. And that turned out to be enough of an inspiration. You know, we were just trying to look like we were competitive. We have 24 brand new kids on the team, and we made a goal for ourselves that we were gonna go out every single week and just be better than we were the week before. All the way up until midnight, Saturday night at Worlds, in fact, right after we got off the floor, we had a couple mistakes and we were in second, which we were excited about, but we went to a gym there in Orlando, Florida, and literally worked until midnight till we finally decided it was time for the kids to go to bed, woke up the next morning, and they just left their hearts out on the mat and were able to bring home the 2012 World Championship. And I didn't really believe that cheerleading could ever get better than the experience of 2010, but I have to say that pure, just raptured joy and emotion of having, and it just kind of took on the persona of every single thing those kids went through all season long. It was really breathtaking to see that all come together perfectly at the exact right moment. One of my favorite quotes is that the boxer who is ready is not necessarily, you don't have to be ready all year, you just have to be ready for when the bell rings, and that's usually the victor. So in that case, that was a great joy for us and a big win for our program. And so those kids, so we didn't have a notch built out, but we do have this really cool piece of furniture. And the same thing, this is 2012 and the gold medal. This is our team mom, Kathy Lukens, always sprinkled this gold dust on the kids. So she left one for my two girls, Carly and Kinley. So we'll keep that, you know, as good luck as they age up through the program. And this is our awesome little nook we had built out of our house for our majors win. The majors, in my experience, was one of the greatest all-star cheerleading moments as a coach possible. The level of glamour and prestige that they made all of the kids feel, whether they won the event or just participated in it, was unprecedented for our sport. Jamfest really outdid themselves. We're really looking forward to this season representing again. And so just in the tradition of Senior Elite, when the kids get to make the major, make a major win, this was our first, this is the first time that ever been held. We were the very first champions. This team got sponsored to go to Europe and represent All-Star Cheerleading, and were able to do a performance in Liverpool that was so much fun. It was awesome to have a team, honestly, whose cell phones didn't work because I got to really bond with them and there was no texting while you're in Europe. But other than that, the sights and the history and the last ability, honestly, to compete with some of my seniors was awesome. So we're really thankful to JamFest for making that happen. And again, all of our athletes' signatures are here, so we get to visit these names every day. The hope is when they're older and they come back to visit, there'll be, you know, a little piece of them here at our home.